Welcome to my channel. My name is Unomfundo Zondi, and if you're new here, you're so welcome. Click that subscribe button, like this video, and leave a comment down below. Click that bell so you can be notified every time I upload a new video. Sheesh, I'm running out of breath. Okay, so guys, I have with me a special guest today. Please introduce yourself.
My name is Lois Mills, and I'm a missionary from the United States of America.
We're so happy to have you.
Thank you.
And as you might have seen by today's title, we're going to be talking about faith. As the saying goes, if you have faith, you have everything. And so let's get into it. Please share with us, what does it mean to have faith, and how does it have an impact in our lives?
Okay, first and foremost, I'm going to go back to what the Bible says. So I'm going to go back to Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. It begins with, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence not seen. So you hope for it, but you don't see it. And so that's what the Word of God says. Mm-hmm. In actuality, faith is accepting as true what God reveals in His Word. Mm-hmm. If you go back again and turn the pages of the Bible, we see God promises. And so we are standing on His promises. And so once we are standing on His promises, we are taking God at His word.
Yes.
And we are believing what He says.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Talking about believing, what advice would you give someone who is struggling with their faith? They are believers, they're Christians, they're saved,
mm-hmm.
but they really are struggling with their faith and trusting God in His word and His promises and standing by what God says.
This Christian journey is not an alone journey.
Mm-hmm.
And so there are a lot of times we as Christians, we need someone to walk alongside us. Someone who is mature, you know, reaching to that level in their walk with the Lord to be an encouragement to you. And so what that mentor would do is go back to the very basic, the foundation, the Word of God, where they will take you back to the Word of God and show you in the Word of God where God again promises us.
Yeah.
You know, God is about 8,810 promises when you go back to the Bible in the Word of God. And God gives us His promises. They are within our reach, okay? Mm-hmm. Not in your hands. And so that's where faith comes in, because they're not in your hands. You stand on the Word of God. You stand on His promises. That's our foundation in life. As we go through this journey, as we walk this journey.
Mm. I like something you said. You mentioned that if we have faith, we can access everything. Faith in Christ gives us access to everything we need in life, everything we need to be happy, everything we need to succeed and to live in full purpose. And I just like that. But how do I build my faith in Christ? Like, how do I strengthen it?
You go back to the Word of God.
Yeah.
Praying,
yeah.
Studying,
yeah.
Fellowshipping,
mm.
communing with the Lord.
Yeah.
Okay, that's where you build, that's where your faith is begin to build.
Yeah.
Staying in prayer.
Yeah.
Communing with the Lord. Staying in the Word of God.
Mm.
Studying the Word of God.
Mm.
You see, you cannot build your faith if you don't know the God of the Bible. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you know the God of the Bible by studying the Word of God. And as you begin again to know the God, to get to know God in a better way, that's when your faith begins to increase, to build, because then you believe the God that you serve.
Amen. You are on the spot. Do you have any strategies on how we can study the Bible?
As a Bible study leader, usually I do precept and precept.
Mm-hmm.
K. Arthur is a magnificent and wonderful teacher, where she have us to go through the Word of God precept upon precept, line upon line.
Yeah.
And so as you study the Bible precept upon precept, line upon line, you stay in context, because context always rules.
Yeah.
You cannot just take one verse and take it and run with it.
You
got to go back, okay, and see, what is the author saying to you? What is this writer saying to you? okay? You got to look back at history. And so as you go through it line upon line and you're going back and you're getting the whole picture, then you get a better understanding of what the Word of God is saying to you and what God is revealing to you about Himself. So I like precept. Personally, I like precept from precept. It's called exegesis. Okay? The Word of God.
Thank you so much for sharing that with us. And we're going to round this video up. Please comment down below if you'd like a part two with Auntie Lois. if she'd allow me. But comment down below and tell us if you'd like a part two of this kind of video. And like I said, please subscribe, like this video, leave a comment down below. And I really hope this video will help you today to find your faith in Christ, to stand by Him and with Him, because He is with you. And yeah, that is it for today's video, guys. Thank you for watching. Bye.
Thank you.